Welcome to Disney Coast to Coast. If you haven't done so yet, be sure to hit that subscribe button. And don't forget to tap that bell icon to be notified every time a new video is released. Thanks!
Do you dream of fairies and princesses? Then you've come to the right place. Welcome to Disney Coast to Coast.
Hey folks, and welcome to Disney Coast to Coast, the ultimate unofficial Disney fan podcast. I'm Jeff DePauly, and in today's House of Mouse headlines, I discuss new restaurants coming to both Disneyland and Disney California Adventure, a new song release from Frozen the Musical, and is Honey, I Shrunk the Kids getting rebooted? That and so much more, so let's get to it.
Here are the latest news from the Walt Disney Company in today's House of Mouse headlines.
Okay, at the top here, I want to start with something that seemed to have come out of nowhere. Zombies, the Disney Channel original movie, premiered this past week. Now, this is something we have discussed on the show a while back when they announced this project of Zombies, which is basically a zombie cheerleader musical, Disney Channel original movie. But for some reason, I hadn't heard anything about it up until its premiere date. I find this very strange. I don't know if this is just me. I don't watch Disney Channel all that often, so maybe they were promoting it a lot on there, but I do feel like with most Disney Channel original movies, I hear a lot of promotion on it on Twitter and social media. This seemed to come out of nowhere. I will say, I did sit down and watch it, and I very much enjoyed it. I thought Zombies was quite fun. It had a very High School Musical feel to it. So if you're in a High School Musical, you'll probably like Zombies. I thought it was a lot of fun. Also, speaking of Disney Channel original movies, Descendants 3 is official. It's coming in summer of 2019, and it looks like Mal's dad is going to be part of the story now. They showed a teaser for this during the Zombies premiere, so Descendants fans, get excited. Summer 2019, Descendants 3. Now, a new show that I find pretty exciting. It looks like the Muppets are getting yet another chance. As you probably know already, the Muppets was a show on ABC just a couple seasons ago, lasted only one season, didn't do terribly well in the ratings and reviews. But they're going to be getting another shot for Disney's streaming service, which is set to premiere in fall of 2019. Not 100% sure when the Muppet Show would start there. We don't have a new title yet or anything, but I'm excited to see that Disney is still investing in the Muppets, still trying to make them as great as they once were. They're still looking for writers and a team to develop this show, from what I understand. So I love the Muppets. I would love for more people to love the Muppets, and hopefully all goes well this time around. Speaking of the Disney streaming service, we also got some potential reboots. Now, one of the things that Disney has already announced they're going to be doing with the streaming service is they'll be creating new original movies for there. And by original, I just mean new, because in a lot of cases, there are some reboots that they're talking about. Father of the Bride, which was a Touchstone / Disney movie with Steve Martin back in, I believe it was the 90s. They're talking about a reboot of that. They're also discussing a reboot of The Parent Trap, which of course is an old classic for Disney, but they've already rebooted once with Lindsay Lohan, and now they want to reboot it again. But the one that piques my interest, and I don't know if I'm excited or terrified about this, but Honey, I Shrunk the Kids is being discussed for a reboot for the Disney streaming service. Of course, this is somewhat exciting to me because, as you probably know, I love Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, but it's also kind of one of those movies, very much like Hocus Pocus, where I'm like, why do we need to remake this? Like, the original is perfect. Why do we have to mess around with that? So I don't know. Honey, I Shrunk the Kids without Rick Moranis, that's kind of like a major bummer. I also love, like, part of the reason as a kid why I loved Honey, I Shrunk the Kids so much was the special effects in the film. I was really into special effects as a kid, and I love all of those old practical effects. So knowing that this new movie would really be all computer-generated stuff, that kind of disappoints me quite a bit as well. So I don't know. If they make a Honey, I Shrunk the Kids reboot, I will most certainly watch it. I just don't know how I'm going to feel about it. That's the only thing. But in any case, it's exciting to hear Disney talk about Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. Maybe if they do reboot it and it does well, maybe the original trilogy will be released on a really nice Blu-ray box set with some special features. That would be great. I'm all for that. And more movie news, we heard that the live-action Pinocchio film that's being done is going to begin production this upcoming fall, and the director of the Paddington films, Paul King, will be directing the film. The Paddington movies, I admittedly have not seen, but have done very well, and I've heard great things about them. I know people that really love Paddington and Paddington 2. So hopefully Paul King does a fantastic job with Pinocchio as well. Of the live-action movies that Disney's doing, from animated to live-action, Pinocchio's pretty exciting for me. I think that that's kind of cool. I'm curious to see how they deal with Pinocchio, because I could see it being a person. I could also see it being a CG figure, which is probably what it's going to be. But I don't know. It should be interesting, but it's nice to see that they've got the project in the hands of a very successful director already. Now, several episodes back, I did mention to you folks that the Wrinkle in Time sneak peek was happening at Disney California Adventure, as well as at Walt Disney World at Disney's Hollywood Studios. And I did say to my friend cast members out there working at the Disneyland Resort, if Oprah Winfrey ever shows up to the Wrinkle in Time sneak peek, please let me know. Give me a call. Give me a heads up. I'll be there. Well, sadly, I never got that call. But Storm Reid, Mindy Kaling, Reese Witherspoon, and Oprah Winfrey from Wrinkle in Time all showed up at Disney California Adventure for the sneak peek to present it to a live audience. Very exciting. At least it would be very exciting for me if I were there. But I wasn't. But congratulations to those of you who were. I hope that you appreciate it. You were in a room with Oprah Winfrey. That's kind of amazing. Speaking of Oprah, apparently her face is being projected on the Chinese theater at Disney's Hollywood Studios these days, thanks to my friend Aaron Wallace, who tweeted out that the Disney Movie Magic projection show at Disney's Hollywood Studios is now featuring a little segment of Wrinkle in Time. So I love the fact that they keep updating and changing this show, and of course it's a great promotional tool for the film as well. But Oprah on the Chinese theater, that's a win. Speaking of Disney's Hollywood Studios, apparently there will be some extra magic hours coming up for Toy Story Land opening on June 30th. Every day it will be opening an hour early for Walt Disney World Resort guests, and then extra 2 hours on Friday evenings for a while, beginning June 30th, just to deal with the crowds for Toy Story Land. It is very interesting to me that this park that has like always had, or for the last several years, had the lowest numbers, is now getting ready for these wild crowds. It's going to be very exciting to see how they handle it, number one, but also I'm excited to see a full park there again. It's going to be really exciting once all of that happens. Now, going on over at Epcot, the Wonders of Life Pavilion got a little bit of love recently with a new roof refurbishment, and this area has actually been used for the different festivals that go on at Epcot for quite some time now, for the last 10 years, in fact, because it's been closed down for attractions since 2007. But recently, not only did they refurbish that roof, some Imagineers and executives have been spotted hanging around that area, checking it out. So looks like something exciting is going to be happening with that pavilion in the near future. I'm a little surprised, actually. I expected that pavilion would just get knocked down entirely and built from the ground up, but it sounds like they're going to be doing something new with it. So I'm excited to hear what that is. Of course, tons of changes are coming to Epcot, so not too much of a surprise that they're going to do something with that land. Speaking of new things, very excited about this new restaurant/food area. Not really sure exactly what it is. Coming to the Disneyland Resort, more specifically at Adventureland, where Aladdin's Oasis currently resides, they're going to be getting rid of Aladdin's Oasis for a new area called the Tropical Hideaway, which of course ties very nicely into the lyrics from the Tiki Tiki Room, "Welcome to our Tropical Hideaway." Yeah, nice. I like it. Good name for it. And this is a cool little area that's going to be themed to not only the Enchanted Tiki Room, but also the Jungle Cruise. It's going to be an outdoor seating area. Sounds like there's going to be some food options. It looks more like a quick service thing to me, but you're going to get cool views of the Jungle Cruise, which has never really happened before at Disneyland. So I'm pretty excited about this. It looks cool. And as far as the concept art shows, looks like there might even be some animatronic birds out there. And if you don't know, the Enchanted Tiki Room's original purpose was to be a restaurant. So that eventually, the idea of that went away and it became more of a show. But Walt Disney's original concept was for it to be a restaurant. So I just love how this ties into Disney history, also gives us something new, also has a cool, catchy name. And the view of the Jungle Cruise is very exciting. Maybe they'll even put some animals there. Who knows? Another new restaurant coming to the Disneyland Resort is Lamplight Lounge. As we all know, Pixar Pier is getting ready to open on June 23rd. That is when Lamplight Lounge will open as well. I love the name of this as well. This is such a great name. Lamplight Lounge, of course, we're talking about Luxo Jr. here, as far as the Lamplight is concerned. So the whole theme of it will be Pixar, just like Pixar Pier. Now, the question everybody wanted to know, because apparently those are so popular, yes, the lobster nachos are returning, so don't worry. Ariel's Grotto, of course, is going away to make way for this, as well as the Cove Bar. The Cove Bar will be temporarily reopened for a little while, so if you're a diehard Cove Bar fan, like a lot of people are, make sure you check it out between March 2nd through May. It sounds like it'll be reopened until it's gone forever. Now, this restaurant will be decorated with concept art from Pixar. They say there's going to be sketches on the napkins, which I think is kind of cool. If they have, like, different designs for the different cocktail napkins, that should be pretty neat. They're going to have knickknacks and collectible toys all around the area. Honestly, it sounds a little bit cheap to me just in the description. We didn't really get any concept art for this, so I don't know. But the way that they describe it makes me think of Pizza Rizzo over at Disney's Hollywood Studios. I hope it's more than that. Pizza Rizzo was a huge disappointment. Pizza Rizzo, if you're not familiar with it, basically it's a Muppet-themed restaurant, but it basically looks like any old restaurant with some Muppet pictures hanging on the wall. I hope there's more detail in Lamplight Lounge than there is in Pizza Rizzo, but it's coming, part of Pixar Pier. Now some stuff happening over at Disneyland Paris Resort that I find interesting. This is the second year for this. I don't remember hearing about this last year. It's called Electroland, and this is the second edition, which will be on June 29th and 30th. There are ticket packages on sale currently. And this happens over at Walt Disney Studios Park. Apparently, they bring in a lot of DJs. They do projections on the tower. It kind of just sounds like an EDM concert, which seems kind of out of place, but also kind of cool. DJ Robin Schultz will be part of it. Bob Sinclair. Klingandy. Sorry, I don't know who these people are, so might be saying that wrong. Klingandy, that's my best guess. Dimitri Vegas and Like Mike, DJ Afrojack, Mo Simon, Lovely Laura, and DJ Ben Santiago. If you know who those people are and you want to see them, head to Disneyland Paris for Electroland. I'm curious, are any of you going to this? If anybody listening to this is going to Electroland, please, write into the show, head to DisneyCoastToCoast.com and click on the FAQ so that you can contact us. And let me know, I'd love to have you on the show and talk to me about this, because I find this very interesting and intriguing. Also happening at Disneyland Paris, the Magic Pass is headed that way. That's right, Disneyland is going to be testing the Magic Pass beginning in March with guests staying at Hotel New York. This is basically kind of like a Magic Band, but it's just like the plastic ticket that some people are used to. So it would work as your resort key, your park tickets, good for your food and merch as well. No mention of Fast Pass being attached to it, but it does sound like it's heading in that direction of, you know, less paper tickets and the plastic card instead, and maybe that will eventually turn into a Magic Band because, of course, it's all the same technology. So Disneyland Paris is stepping it up a notch. Heading over to Broadway, Frozen the Musical is getting ready to open. In fact, it's in previews already, and they did release a song from it. They shot a music video, and from what I understand, they're going to start releasing these more and more often, so we should hear a lot of the new music coming from Frozen the Musical, which is very exciting. The song is called Monster, and it's Elsa's song. It's very pop, but also very dark. One of the lines in the song is, "If I die, will they be free?" So it's heading in a, you know, Elsa's really questioning whether or not, I mean, she's quote unquote a bad person. Is she causing these problems, and will people be better off without her? Some people call it like a suicide song. I wouldn't go that far, but it is a bit darker than I think we're used to from the animated film. I'm pretty excited about this new music. I gotta say, I liked it. I actually listened to it twice in a row. I was like, this is a pretty cool song for Elsa. And I think the new music coming from the musical may end up being the best part of it, even more so than the production value, which looks really nice. But I don't know, the new music is pretty exciting. So go check that out if you haven't already. It's called Monster from Frozen the Musical. And happening here in Los Angeles on Tuesday, February 27th, it will be declared Coco Day in LA at the Los Angeles City Hall. Yeah, that's right, an official day for the Disney Pixar film Coco. The proclamation will begin at 9 a.m. and feature performances of Un Poco Loco and Remember Me, of course, the hit songs from the film. And, of course, this was nominated for Best Animated Film and Best Song on this upcoming Sunday's Academy Awards. So if you're a fan of the film Coco, head on to downtown LA this Tuesday, February 27th. Now that's going to do it for the news this week, but on this past Wednesday's episode of Disney Coast to Coast, I wanted you guys to join the conversation over on YouTube, and I asked you which of the new songs from Aladdin, the Broadway musical, is your favorite, because of course this past week's episode was all about Aladdin, the Broadway musical. If you haven't listened yet, make sure you check that out. But as far as you guys were concerned, Mega Soul Hero says they like Proud of Your Boy, The rest is pretty forgettable. That was Mega Soul Hero's comment. I would agree, I like Proud of Your Boy quite a bit. Brian Nussbaum says High Adventure is the favorite song. Ryo Nakazawa said A Million Miles Away, as well as Diego Parada said A Million Miles Away. Another vote for Proud of Your Boy from Meg Wilshire. And Ashley Okamura says High Adventure. So sounds like Proud of Your Boy, High Adventure, Million Miles Away. Those are the popular songs from Aladdin, the Broadway musical. Also over on Twitter, we had a Twitter poll asking my favorite Disney Renaissance animated film is, and the options I gave you were The Little Mermaid, Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, and The Lion King. Now, number four, this was a very surprising poll. I gotta tell you guys, you shocked me with this one. Little Mermaid came in last place with 11% of the votes. Lion King came in second with 19%, Aladdin with 25% of the votes, and way ahead at number one, Beauty and the Beast got 45% of the votes. I was shocked by this. Not that Beauty and the Beast isn't phenomenal, it is. I thought it would be a tighter race, number one, and I never thought Little Mermaid would be in last place. It's very, very surprising to me. But in any case, that's the Twitter poll. If you want to become part of the Twitter poll, make sure you're following Disney Coast to Coast on Twitter at DizneyCTC. That's DizneyCTC. If you want to join the conversation, make sure you head over to YouTube for the Wednesday episodes and leave a comment there with the question of the week. Don't forget, guys, this upcoming Friday, March 2nd, is the first Q&A live stream, which is part of the Patreon support group there. So make sure you go to patreon.com/DCTC or head to DisneyCoastToCoast.com and click on that Patreon tab. You can also join the e-note to get our music playlist, and our social media is at DisneyCoastToCoast.com. Don't forget to rate and review us on iTunes, all that fun stuff. And of course, the Daily Disney Decision is still happening every single day over on Instagram Live. That is DizneyCTC over on Instagram. Hope to see you guys there, but for now, have a magical day. Bye!
Thanks for watching Disney Coast to Coast. Have a magical day!
Disney Coast to Coast is produced and hosted by Jeff DePauly. Learn more about the podcast and become a supporter at DisneyCoastToCoast.com.